Good day, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Safety Moment with Wadiola. And 2 weeks back, we discussed about how to identify hazard, the method to use, the PPE, the people, the procedure, that is the process, then the plant, the equipment, and the environment. Last week, we spoke about how to give an analysis of our risk assessment, how to do our risk assessment, and know how risky or less risky, how hazardous or less hazardous our any hazard we spot, how hazardous this is, and we explained that in our last discussion. So this week, we'll be talking about after identifying them and giving them the hierarchy, yeah, and giving them the assessment. Now we are talking about, we are going to talk about the control measures briefly. Now in the control measures, we have basically 5 hierarchy of safety control measures. Five of them. We have the elimination, we have the substitution, we have the engineering control, we have the administrative control, and we have the PPE. Always remember that I usually try to relate it with our immediate home, our environment, so that we start safety practice from our homes. So when we're talking about elimination, we mean that we are trying to remove the hazard. From the word eliminate, we are trying to remove the hazard from existing. So that is elimination. And the first point of elimination is that in our home is that every time we want to buy any equipment, anytime we want to buy any appliance at home, the first thing that should come to our mind is the safety implication. Safety should always be our first point of contact. We want to buy an equipment, okay, does it have these control measures? Is it safer to use than this? Does it have this? Does it have that? You look at those safety measures to know the kind of equipment you put in your home. So that is the first basis of elimination. That is, you don't want anything that, you don't want to introduce any hazardous substance or any hazardous salt into your home. Then secondly, another example of elimination is when you try to outsource. It's being used in most companies, okay, you don't want to do this process in our company because it's bringing a lot of smokes and we don't want the smoke in our environment. Okay, let us outsource it outside to another company to do it. They just bring it for us. You can do that in your kitchen, you know. You see, my wife, I don't want to stress yourself. Ergonomic hazard, the stress, hazard going to, okay, let us go to Domino Pizza and just eat and come back home. Yes, you've done elimination, the stress and the work of trying to cook. You've eliminated the hazard, it's part of elimination. So you can try to practice that at home every time, but I don't know how long it will go. Another example of when you try to, I think those two is enough, but basically elimination means that you are trying to reduce the hazard to the, you are trying to remove it from existing. You are taking it off, you don't want it to exist, and you don't want it to exist. The first thing is that safety must be point of concern. The secondly, you are trying to what, outsource it outside so that the hazard will know what exists in your home. The second one is substitution. When you say you are substituting, it means that you are removing a more hazardous substance, a more hazardous stuff, a more hazardous, a more risky stuff. You are removing it and putting a less hazardous substance, a less hazardous situation, a less hazardous condition. That is, you are removing and you are substituting it with something that is less hazardous. That is that about substitution. That's easy as that. Example of substitution, which one can I even think of now? Example, there are a lot of examples of substitution anyway, but basically what you are doing is that you are trying to remove a more hazardous stuff and you are introducing less hazardous stuff. Let's say, for example, in your home, okay, in the cooking section, in the electrical section, you don't want to use electrical appliance because of shock, then you are trying to reduce gas cooker. Meanwhile, gas cooker has its own hazard, you shouldn't forget. But because of the effect of electric shock, maybe there has been recent occurrence, maybe there is rain falling frequently and there has been electrical shock, you can as well reduce it to what, something that won't give you that shock, or reducing the intensity of the shock. Another example of substitution is, what else can I even think of? Another example of substitution, we are substituting something for something. There are a lot of examples of substitution anyway, let me waste the time. Then the next one is engineering control. Engineering control means that you are trying to create a barrier between the hazard and the person. You are trying to reduce the level of exposure between the hazard and the person. That is engineering control. It's applicable in our homes. Like, for example, we decided, okay, no anybody, no kids, you enter the kitchen. 5 and below, if you want to eat, they will bring your food for you. If you need water, water will be in the sitting room because of the hazard that are inherent what in the kitchen. So you have done what you have created. You have created the barrier. That is an example of what of engineering by using padlock, not by saying it with mouth. You locked the kitchen and you restrict the access to what to the kitchen. That's an example of what engineering control. Using of fuse in your homes, our electrical appliances use, they are part of engineering control. The process you are using to do your work, trying to make it easier, that is part of what? Part of engineering control. Creating a guard maybe where you used to change your electrical appliance, you now build a guard or this cage so that nobody just get access to it. Proper ventilation of your home too is part of engineering control. Isolating a particular part of your home, okay, nobody should get to this place. Restricting the movement to that place is also part of what? Engineering control. So now next week, you'll be giving us more example of elimination, substitution, administrative. Then we'll now engineering, then we'll now go to administrative control. And the last one, which is PPE. This one very, very fast because it's like I have a lot of things to do now. I just have to find time to give us this episode of Safety Moment with Aliola. Always remember to ask questions, drop your comments, like our post, follow us on Instagram, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Even if it's one person that we have, at least we know that we are also contributing to the safe living in our environment. I wish you all a lovely week ahead. I remain Aliola Adegoke, your safety professional. Thank you. See you next week.